welcome. Don't forget to like and subscribe and click on the bell to receive notifications.
نعم نعم. ما ورد في فتح المنعم في شرح صحيح في شرح صحيح مسلم لموسى شاهين لاشين الجزء الخامس صفحة 222 أنه قال أنه يدخل عليها الغلام الأيسع وكانت عائشة رضي الله عنها ترى أن أرضاع الكبير يحرم وأرضعت غلاما فعلا وكان يدخل عليها. فهل كانت عائشة ترضع شباب قريش؟ هل يجوز ذلك أن تعطيهم الحليب من صدرها؟
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be upon everyone. Yesterday I left a comment.
He wants to come to your house to experience.
Aisha would not disclose any matter which degrade the wife and the Prophet, peace upon him. And this is not the way of Islamic teaching, because Islam is very protective to our women.
So let me
I didn't finish. Let me finish.
Finish quickly. I
know that you're always. Let me respond.
Okay, just get on.
Islam, if you know, sometimes when a male came to visit, we set the male in one room and the female in another room. So it's not a way that we invite strange people to come and suck the breath of our women, because we can suck them as well, our women. It's not a way that we invite strange people to come and suck the breath of our women, because we can suck them as well, our women. It's our right to enjoy love. Up to you.
بلوك على الفيسبوك، بلوك على الواتساب، بلوك تليفونات، بلوك انستغرام، بلوك 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 عفل بلوك بلوك.
I hope you all got that one. Yes, they do invite strangers to come and suck the breast of their wives. So here's a couple of comments. If yes, come. Oh, he wants. I'll come.
Salam alaikum.
One hour later.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Hello, welcome. Don't forget to like and subscribe and click on the bell to receive notifications. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment that you all have been waiting for. We are live! Live. You are listening to the live broadcast of your friendly neighbor, Stream Doctor and Christian Apologist. The most wanted man, the undisputed, the undefeated public enemy of Islam. And your favorite YouTuber, Rob Christian. Please fasten your seatbelts. Houston, we are ready for takeoff. We are back, baby. We are here to stay. Let's go. Hello, guys. Welcome. God bless you. Thank you for being here. Nice to have you on board. I hope everybody is healthy, okay, and whole. God bless everybody who is here in the live chat. Admins, welcome. Take my live chat from now on. It's yours, admins. It's your in your hands. Deborah Rye, Tony King, what's up, Tony? Dragon Daenerys, God bless you. Sister Eden, welcome. God bless you. Aaron Staley in the house. Sin or C1, how are you, brother? Another admin. Phil Herrera, present. What's up, Phil? Are there more admins? I'm not sure if there are more admins. It's awesome that there are so many admins here. God bless you guys. Thank you for taking care of my live chat, of my channel for me. Keep our admins in your prayers, guys. Also, hello to Mamad Hubloop, an ex-Muslim. Welcome, my friend. Nice to have you here. JB, Jolaina, sorry if I butchered your name, welcome. Katka, hello. Robert Pate. Chris Claus, too, in the house. Wow, guys. Keep our brother Chris Claus, another admin, and a very dear brother of mine, an amazing debater from the Poltalk area, Aria. So keep him also in your prayers, guys, and subscribe to his YouTube channel, Chris Claus, my dear brother. Old school debater. Umut, hello, Umut. How are you, Umut? Nice to have you here. Information is wealth. Welcome. Wow, there are so many people already. That's awesome, guys. Awesome. Deus Vult. Lord willing. Exactly. Welcome to you too, my friend. Deus Vult 1.5. Ivan Petar. Bedis. Sorry, guys. I cannot mention all of your names, but you're all welcome here, including the Muslims. Muslims, welcome. May God, may our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, open your eyes for the truth, nothing but the truth. I'll pray for all of you Muslims because we have hope for everybody to be saved. I know you curse us at least 70 times a day when you pray your daily five prayers. You hate us, you curse us, but we are not like you because the love of Christ is much more powerful than the hate of your Allah, who is nobody else than Satan in disguise. The love of Christ will conquer everything. Welcome, guys. Keep us in your prayers. Keep our ministry in your prayers. Don't underestimate the power of prayers, guys. Truly don't underestimate the power of prayers. Keep us warriors in Christ who are putting our lives on the front lines to destroy this cult with the truth. Keep us in your prayers, please. Please. As you know, guys, today's topic is the true love story of the Prophet Muhammad and Zainab. Muhammad and Zainab bint Jahsh, the daughter of the donkey. Yeah, that's her last name. Guys, I have nothing to do with it. That's what her name is, the daughter of the donkey, Zainab bint Jahsh. So, Muhammad stealing the wife of his adopted son, right, and blaming Allah for it. Subhan muqallib al-qulub. Glory to Allah who turns hard when Muhammad saw her body, right, half naked. You know, Muhammad went to see his son, his adopted son Zayd, who was called Zayd bin Muhammad, right? He was the adopted son of Muhammad and Khadija, his first wife. Right, so after Khadija died, Muhammad started to lust for women left and right. Imagine, as long as Khadija was alive, Muhammad, the woman of the house, would not dare in the presence of his first wife Khadija to lust after other women because she's his boss. She is the richest woman of Mecca. Do you think that Khadija would allow any other women to come in between her and Muhammad? Of course not. So the moment Khadija dies, the fun starts for the perverted, lustful prophet with an eye, by the way, prophet with an eye of Islam. So before we actually start, guys, I want to ask you to pray with me. To pray with me, especially let us keep our Indonesian family in Christ in your prayers, guys. We need to pray for them. You know what happened, guys? Today, I received a couple of messages from our brothers from Indonesia. Brothers and sisters, Carolina sent me also a message, a dear admin here. And they told me about what happened. Sad news, but what I understood, there were no deaths on the Christian side, right? Only the jihadi, the suicide, cowardice jihadi on motorbikes, they died, right? They committed suicide, right? In an explosion. But only the gate, I think only the gate was damaged. That's what I understood. A couple of people were, were injured. So pray for them, guys, for them to recover soon. And keep them in your prayers. Our dear brothers and sisters in Christ in Indonesia. They are really in a difficult country. It's really hard to live as a Christian in such countries. Not only Indonesia, Pakistan, Egypt, Syria, Iraq, all these countries, right? Where Islam is ruling. So guys, I want to ask you to pray with me in the name of the Father, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. بإسم الأب والابن والروح القدس. We pray. نحن نصلي. We pray. Lord Christ, thank you for allowing me to do another live stream again today on short notice. Please bless our audience, all the admins, and our subscribers. Lord Christ, thank you for coming into this world to save us from death, from eternal damnation. You came to wash our wicked flesh, to wash away the sins of the world. We are washed and we are justified in your holy name, O Christ. Your name above all names, O Lord Jesus Christ. We really needed you, Jesus, in our lives, because without you, we would have been lost, completely lost. You are our joy in this world. Lord, I want to ask you to keep my wife and baby boy healthy and safe. And please protect our Indonesian brothers and sisters who are having a really difficult time in Indonesia. The cathedral, as you see, cathedral that we mentioned, O Lord, please protect the Christians in Indonesia. Please keep them safe, O Lord Christ. Please also bless our audience who are now listening and watching to our very live stream. Thank you for this awesome audience and subscribers, our supporters on Patreon who always support us for so many months and years now. Please bless them and their loved ones and families. Please, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Keep all of us healthy and safe, O Christ. And Jesus, I want to ask you to give us a measure of your strength so that we might not give into any taqiyah, any fear, any tawriya, any makr, any deception, any lie or any doubt, O Lord. Please help us honor you in all our ways. Christ, I pray to you and ask you to shine your holy light on all of us, including the Muslims who might be in need and are seeking for the truth, because they are disgusted of the teaching of Muhammad, this evil cult of Muhammad, the violence that Muhammad taught. Please open their eyes so also they can be saved. We don't hate them, O Christ. We love them. This is why we need to destroy Islam, so they can drop Muhammad and come back home to you, O Christ. Lord, fill me with your Holy Spirit and loosen my tongue today and guide me so I can speak the truth, nothing but the truth, without any error or any shame, because we should not be ashamed about the truth, O Lord. And give us wisdom and courage to do whatever needs to be done. In Jesus' holy name, we pray. Amen. Amen. We are live, baby. We are back and we are here to stay. And no Muslim can do anything about it. Keep trying, Muslims. Keep trying to silence us. But we are here to expose your prophet and your man-made religion, left and right. You cannot do anything about it. So again, guys, please welcome. Please keep our Indonesian brothers and sisters in your prayers on this very holy day. Keep them in your prayers. Don't underestimate the powers of prayers, guys. Please, many people have no idea how powerful the Christian prayers are. Please, God, keep them safe. Keep our brothers and sisters in Indonesia safe. Protect them. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Please keep them safe. All right, guys. Our main topic today, and you saw the intro, we're going to talk about this, the true love story of the Prophet between Muhammad, right, the Prophet of Islam, and Zainab, his daughter-in-law. That's the main topic of today. But before I go there, I want to discuss first, and you saw the intro, the adult breastfeeding or suckling in Islam. The adult breastfeeding or suckling in Islam. Man, look at this picture. Man. David Wood, brother. I forgot the name of this guy. He's also an awesome Christian brother. Look at this. And this is a Muslima brother who they hired, they paid for muta, brother. And they are putting milk inside the cup to drink it, brother. So they will become her mahram, right? Look at this, brother. Hey, brother. Milk in a cup, brother. Don't do it directly from the nipple, brother. Yeah, Vocab Malone. Yeah, that's his name. Brother Vocab Malone. I mean, when I saw this video, guy, I was dying from laughing. You should watch that video. That was amazing. You know what? You know what, guys? You know what? Let me see if I can play that part. It's hilarious. We are here anyway. Right? We have all the time of the world today. I'm here with you guys. And this is going to be a lovely, long live show. So grab some popcorn, brother. Grab some popcorn and let us have some fun with Islam. Let us have some fun with the breast-sucking business of the Prophet of Islam, brother. Muhammad had a huge business in the 7th century, 1400 years ago, brother. And that was called the adult breast-suckling business of Muhammad. Let's see if I can find that part. Brother, sister. Let's see. This part here.
Breast to a stranger.
Do you understand this, my sister?
Brother, sister.
Muta, muta.
No. A sucky, sucky.
Sucky, sucky, $5, brother.
Woo-hoo! My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like,
oh, yeah.
Better than yours, damn right. It's
oh, boy.
Than yours, I could teach you.
Nothing, nothing.
Milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours, damn right. It's better than yours, I could teach you, but I have to charge.
You want it.
Oh, yeah.
The thing that makes me what the guys go crazy for.
Oh, and hair, hair.
The way I want.
Some cookies, brother. Sharon is caring, vocab. In a cup, brother.
Yours, damn right. It's better than yours, I could teach you. But I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours, damn right. It's better than yours, I could teach you. But I have to charge.
On it.
Some chocolate. Oh, yeah, boy.
If you're smart.
La 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 la. Warm it up. La 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 la. The boys are waiting.
Yeah.
La,
la, la. Okay, that's enough. That's enough, guys. That's enough. I mean, look at this. Brother, if you're going to suckle a woman in Islam, make sure it's inside a cup, brother. Alright? Do it inside a cup. Don't do it straight from the nipple, brother. That's not sunnah, brother. Are you sure? Are you sure, brother? Are you sure? Yeah. That's what they said. Make sure it's from a cup, brother. Make sure it's from a cup. Don't do it directly from the nipple, brother. That's not sunnah, brother. Haram, brother. All right? The woman should not expose her melons for you to suckle from directly from the nipple. There is no contact between the lips of the men with the big beard. Only inside a cup, brother. That's what Muhammad taught us. Are you sure? Is that true, guys? Let us expose that lie. Right?
Let us expose that lie. Let me expose all the Muslim apologists, like Fifi, Mimi, all of them, these liars and deceivers, one by one. Are you ready, guys? I said, are you ready? I did not hear you. I said, are you ready? Let's go. Let's go, guys. Yes! We are ready. Let's go. All right. Oh, man. The one who made these pictures, man. These paintings. Anyway, guys, you know the famous hadith. Sunan ibn Majah, hadith number 1944. Again, Sunan ibn Majah, hadith number 1944. This is classed as Sahih by Ibn Hazm, Hassan, and Hassan by Al-Albani. So it's accepted, it's Sahih, it's Hassan, right? Where are the Muslims who dare to say, well, it's da'if, brother? Any Muslim? Let me open Skype, guys. Hello, Yasmin Qureshi, welcome. Yeah, sure, no problem, Yasmin Qureshi. Guys, our sister Yasmin Qureshi, she left Islam the other day. I think now almost a week and a half, she left Islam and she became a Christian on our live show. So, glory to Jesus Christ. Welcome to Christianity, dear sister Yasmin Qureshi, and all the ex-Muslims who are in the live chat. We have many ex-Muslims in the live chat, guys. So, God bless you again. We love you, dear sister. Dear sister Yasmin, in Christ, welcome. Yeah, you saw her video, guys. Man, that was amazing. We are so happy for you, Sister Yasmin. Don't worry, sister. You know, if you want, our admins here, Deborah Rai, you see his name, Deborah Rai, they can invite you if you like to know more about Christianity. You want to talk to us. Maybe you have some questions. You can join us on Discord, right? We have a couple of servers. We have Brother Jai. Who is also an admin. He has also a server. We have Brother Adam Seeker. I myself don't own a Discord server simply because I don't have time to run a server, guys. Honest to God, that's why. But Adam Seeker, he has an awesome Discord server. Brother Jai. There are many servers that you can join, Yasmin. You can download the app, the Discord app from the App Store, and you can join us there if you like. Yasmin, you're the winner. She's the winner, right? Because she got saved in the name of Christ. Welcome to Christianity, sister. All right. Okay, so Sunan ibn Majah, this hadith, guys. It was narrated that Aisha said, the verse of stoning and of adult breastfeeding 10 times was revealed. So it was Quran. And the paper was with me under my pillow, Aisha said. When the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Allah is praying on him and submit to Muhammad. Yes, that's what the meaning is. Sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We were preoccupied with his death and a tame sheep came in and ate those two verses. Right? The paper where those two verses used to be on. So the Muslims knew about them. They used to recite those verses. Where are they? Muslims will tell you, well, these verses are abrogated. But wait. Wait, ya Muslimin, ya Muslimin, ya Akhwan, can you show me the ayah now in the Quran which abrogated those two verses? Guys, again, focus with me, guys. Don't allow anyone to distract you in the live chat. Again, here's the $1 million question. You Muslims say that these two verses are abrogated. Fine, I will go with you. Which ayah of the Quran abrogated those verses? I mean, remember, Allah, according to his Quran, Allah sends down ayahs that abrogate ayahs, right? He sends down better ayahs or similar ayahs to abrogate earlier ayahs. So again, here's the challenge. Here is the $1 million challenge to all the Muslims, even to Allah and Muhammad himself. Show me the ayah of the Quran that abrogated the verse of stoning and adult breastfeeding. Show me the ayah right here, right now. Any Muslim? Let me open Skype. Is there any Muslim? Is there any Muslim who's going to defend the adult suckling business of his prophet? My Skype is open, brother. See? My Skype is open. Any Muhammadan? Is there any Muhammadan? Mayday, mayday. We have at least one dislike, so at least one Muslim is with us. Can you show me the ayah in the Quran that abrogated the verse of stoning an adult breastfeeding? We know, according to Ubay ibn Ka'b, guys, we know, according to Ubay ibn Ka'b, that verse used to be where? In Surah Al-Ahzab. Yes, you heard it correctly. In Surah Al-Ahzab. That's what Ubay ibn Ka'b himself said. Yes, Ubay ibn Ka'b said that. Right? So we even know where it used to be. And that surah was as big as chapter 2, Surah Al-Baqarah of the Quran, right? Here's my proof, guys. Watch. Right? Surah Al-Ahzab was as long as Surah Al-Baqarah. You see it? Let me scroll down. Look. So Ubay ibn Ka'b, Ubay ibn Ka'b, let's see here. Ubay ibn Ka'b is having a discussion with another person, right? From Zur. So you see, Ubay ibn Ka'b said, how long is Surah Al-Ahzab when you read it? Or how many verses do you think is in it? I said to him, 73 verses. He said, only 73? Wait. Ubay ibn Ka'b is saying, it used to be, there was a time that it was as long as Surah Al-Baqarah. And we read in it, the old man and the old woman, if they commit zina, which is adultery, then stone them both and punishment from Allah, and Allah is Almighty, Most High. So you see, according to Ubay ibn Ka'b, guys, according to Ubay ibn Ka'b, it was in Surah Al-Ahzab. Surah Al-Ahzab. Right? The ayah of stoning, at least the ayah of stoning, used to be, according to Ubay ibn Ka'b, in Surah Al-Ahzab. So we know where it was. So can you show me the ayah that abrogated it? Yeah, Muslimin, can you show me the ayah that abrogated the verse of stoning an adult breastfeeding 10 times? I mean, you Muslims always say Allah abrogates what He likes, or He sends similar, right? With better ayahs or similar ayahs. What's the point of sending the similar ayah anyways? And why would Allah send an ayah and later change his mind like a kid in a candy store? Mom, I don't like this candy, Mom. I need a better candy, Mom. And this is like Allah in a candy store. Right? I want in candy. Allah in a candy store. I love this candy. I love this this ayah. I love this ayah better than this ayah. Okay. Yeah. So where's the ayah, Muslims? Where is the ayah that abrogated the verse of stoning and adult breastfeeding 10 times? I want the ayah from the Quran. Where is it? Ah, brother, it's not there anymore, brother. Allah abrogated that one too, brother. Yeah, right. You see how messed up the Quran is, guys? You see how messed up the Quran is? Anyway. So yeah, the goat of Aisha, brother. The goat came in and ate the verses of the Quran. And this goat is so dangerous that it even went in the hearts of the Muslims. Remember, Muslims always say, we memorized the Quran for the last 1400 years on our hearts. So this goat even can go in the hearts of the believers, of the Muslimin, right? Yeah, Muslimin, this goat is the most wanted goat. It's still somewhere because, you know, when you eat the Quran of Allah, you become uncreated, right? So this goat is now very, very holy goat, brother. It's uncreated, it's eternal goat. The eternal goat of Aisha. Brother. Yasmin, are you with us, Yasmin? Sister Yasmin? Sister Yasmin, now you, that you just left Islam, sister, you know, they say the Muslimin, you used to be a Muslim. They say that the verse of stoning an adult breastfeeding 10 times was in the Quran. It was revealed by Allah through Jibreel to Muhammad. Have you not ever asked yourself, Where is the ayah of the Quran that abrogated the verse of stoning an adult breastfeeding, Sister Yasmin? Have you never asked yourself this question when you used to be a Muslim? Which ayah abrogated the verse of stoning an adult breastfeeding? I want the ayah, man. Right? Any Muslim with a set of healthy brains, healthy brains, should ask himself this question. Which ayah abrogated the verse of stoning an adult breastfeeding 10 times? Right? Because they say it's abrogated. Yeah, Muhammad Saeed, you say, yes, it was just abrogated. By which ayah? By which ayah abrogated it? Which ayah of the Quran abrogated it? Yeah, Muhammad Saeed, look how smart you are. Brother, you are a genius. Guys, give Muhammad Saeed a rose. He's a genius. He says, yeah, it was just abrogated. Okay, abrogated by which ayah? Yeah. Yeah, you see, Yasmin Qureshi says, if I had known about this, I would have left Islam earlier. Exactly. No human being, no smart human being would stay in such a cult when you have a disaster like this to deal with. I mean, the hadith is saying the verse of stoning and adult breastfeeding 10 times was revealed to the Muslimin. Muhammad gave these verses to the Muslimin, to the Sahaba. Okay, fine, I will go with you. And you Muslims say, for the last 1400 years, you say they have been abrogated. Fine, I will go with you again. But can you show me the ayah now in the Quran which abrogated this verse, the verse of stoning an adult breastfeeding 10 times? Yalla, ya Muhammad Saeed. Ya Muhammad Saeed, can you give me the ayah which abrogated this verse? You're a genius, man. You're a genius. Ya Muhammad Saeed, enta shatir, ya akhi. You know, your level of IQ, we can't reach your level of IQ, my friend. Your IQ is 50. I can't reach that, man. You're a genius, man. All of you Muslims are geniuses. Brother. But in the meantime, keep tap dancing because you can't show us the ayah that supposedly abrogated these verses. So the joke is on you, yeah, Muslimin. When you dare to say they are abrogated. Right? They are abrogated. Yes, we still stone. We must stone. Right? But they are abrogated. We must breastfeed, but they are abrogated, brother. The ruling is not abrogated, but the ayahs are abrogated in the Quran. Okay, which ayah abrogated it? Which ayah abrogated it? That's the $1 million question. And, I mean, guys, find this goat. Find this goat, because if we find this goat, we will find finally the real Quran of Allah. Because, you know, yeah. Guys, I mean, you know, look at this. Look, brother, look at this. Tafsir al-Qurtubi, volume 17, page 172, says the following. The following interpretation of the Quran by a renowned Islamic commentator, al-Qurtubi, women are like cows, horses, and camels, for all are ridden. Aha! So I see why the Sahaba had to suckle women, because they are cows and they are to be ridden. I mean, guys, this must be Sauda, one of the wives of Muhammad. I mean, she was huge. Look at this beautiful cow. This must be Sauda then. Right? Because according to Islam, women are like cows. And you know, you must... right? Milk, brother. So, you know, this must be Sauda. Yeah, that's what Islam teaches, guys. Women are like cows, horses, and camels, for all are ridden. So the women in Islam are animals. Woo! You're an animal in Islam. Muhammad even compared you to dogs. I forgot to put the word dogs here. You know, remember what Muhammad used to say in the hadith? You know, a woman and a dog can break your prayer, can cut off your prayer. Imagine you're a man and a woman passes by, a dog, a black dog passes by, your prayer can be annulled because of the dogs and the women. So women are dogs, they are horses and camels, for all are ridden. Woo! That's what Muslims, that's what Islam thinks of women. So if you are a woman in Islam, if you are a Muslimah, do you have any dignity to accept this about yourself, ya Muslimin? Ya Muslimah? Ya Ukhta! Do you accept this about yourself? Do you have any self-respect, any dignity to be called a cow, to be called a cow, a horse, a camel, a dog in Islam? There are many nicknames, right, for women in Islam. Half-brained, I can go all day. All night long, brother. I mean, look at Sauda, brother. She's huge. Yeah, the one of the wives of Muhammad. Guys, I'm not the one saying it. Those are the Muslim scholars who are calling women cows, horses, and camels. I have nothing to do with this. I'm only showing you how Sauda, one of the wives of Muhammad, used to look like. The mother of the believers, Sauda herself. She was huge. Yeah, okay, guys, let us continue. No RC, it doesn't say that RC. Any Muslim? Yeah, guys, keep the mother of Sister Yasmin Qureshi in the live chat. Keep her mother in your prayers. Keep her father in her prayers, in your prayers, guys. Pray for them so they will become Christians like Sister Yasmin here. Please keep all the Muslims in your prayers, guys, because we have hope for everybody. This is why we are doing this, right? Yasmin, our sister here, a couple days ago, she came and she started to ask the right questions, and we helped her, right? We cannot save you, but we can help you and guide you with the truth. Guide you to the truth, and only God can save you. So, clearly, Christ, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, had a plan for Sister Yasmin here. Jesus wanted her back. Right. Guys, I have some screenshots here. This is the screenshot of Mimi Hijab. You know Mimi Hijab, the golden hikmah boy. Get your hikmah boy, right? The golden shower boy. Mimi Hijab himself, look what he's saying. Mimi Hijab said, and I quote, "Okay, can I suck your wife's to make her a mahram?" A brother. Imagine Ali Dawah and Muhammad Hijab, you know, they are friends, right? They are buddies. Muhammad Hijab goes to the house of Ali Dawah. Ali Dawah must allow Mimi Hijab to suck his wife's to become her mahram. Right, Ali Dawah? Yeah, Ali Dawah, did you do that? Did you tell your wife to, you know, give her breast to Mimi Hijab? Because this is sunnah, right? You know, you're a strange man. You come to a woman's house, you know, so you will not start to lust after her. She must give you her your titties, brother. And look at this munafiq here. Bunur says, what kind of mannerism are these, ya Muhammad Hijab? What kind of disgusting behavior? Shame on you, ya Muhammad Hijab. But wait, Muhammad Hijab is practicing sunnah, brother. So I have to give it to Muhammad Hijab. He's at least a real Muslim. Not you, ya Bunur. And then Muhammad Hijab says, why is it wrong? He believes it's halal. Yeah, right. It's halal, brother, to suck on someone's wife's titties. So she, you become her son, basically. You're going to become her son. Then you're allowed to enter the house. That's sunnah. That's Muhammad, his teaching. It's the sunnah of the Prophet, brother. If Bunur is watching, yeah, Bunur, you're a munafiq. You're a munafiq. At least Muhammad Hijab, I have to give it to Muhammad Hijab. At least he follows the sunnah of his prophet. He wants to suck someone's wife's titties. Now, guys, this is Sister Fifi. Sister Fifi, guys, is my special guest today. I'm going to use him to expose his prophet. What? Yes, I'm going to use Sister Fifi and his lies to expose the prophet of Islam, brother. And I know that Sister Fifi always watch my videos, right? I know that Sister Fifi is watching my videos, but this sister Fifi will never ever call me to debate me. Why is that? Ya Muslimin. Right? He is one of the heroes. He is considered to be one of the heroes in 2021 of Islam. He is trying to help the Ummah from drowning even further than it already is. And look what he says. You know, here, Muhammad Hijab, if you were following social media lately, Muhammad Hijab was attacking Sheikh Al-Albani. Sheikh Al-Albani, right? A sheikh who supposedly was originally from Albania. That's why he's called Sheikh Al-Albani, right? A very famous sheikh in the Muslim world, right? A very famous sheikh, Sheikh Al-Albani, who came from Albania. That's why he's called Al-Albani. And he learned Arabic and he learned about hadith and he became a very famous scholar in Islam. Hadith expert, basically. And Muhammad Hijab was making fun of him. And, you know, the whole ummah started to drown and they started to attack Muhammad Hijab for it. Right? Because he was criticizing Sheikh Al-Albani. And you see, Farida, Sister Fifi, he is defending Sheikh Al-Albani. You know, if you are following social media and if you knew what happened on social media, guys, the ummah started to drown the moment Muhammad Hijab said, "Can I please suck your wife's titties? A little sucky sucky here, a little sucky sucky there. Sucky sucky, $5, brother." So let's see what Fifi says, guys. And I quote, "As for Sheikh Al-Albani's position on the matter, he clearly affirms that it's a sin, right, except in a case in which her situation makes it necessity. He mentions that drinking, now guys, pay attention, this is the most important part that I'm going to use today, because I'm going to spank Sister Fifi and all the scholars who deny this, all the Muslim apologists, all the Muslims who love to say, well, the Sahaba, when they used to suck on the titties of married women, in the time of Muhammad, there was no direct contact between the nipple. God have mercy. There was no direct contact between the nipple and the lips of the Sahaba. Guys, are you focusing, please? I'm going to destroy. Guys, you have no idea how important today's live show is. If you didn't watch my short video about this. You have no idea how important today's live show is because I'm going to destroy the 1400 years old lie that, you know, you become mahram, you know, you have to do it inside a cup or a pot. That's the claim, right? The claim is no direct contact. Milk must be poured inside a cup. No direct contact, right? That's the claim. That's the Muslim standard narrative, right? You must pour it inside a cup, brother. That's what Fifi is saying. It's sufficient to create a foster relationship. You see it? So you're going to become mahram, right? It's going to be haram for you to lust after that wife of that man. Let's say Fifi, his wife, right? Fifi's wife, he has a beautiful wife. Sister Fifi has a beautiful wife, right? And Ali Dawa or Muhammad Hijab come to see Farida. And Farida's wife must pour the milk inside a cup. Brother, no direct contact between the lips of Mimi or Lily. But the wife of Farida must milk inside a cup, brother. Guys, I hope you're following. That's what they are saying, right? The milk, the breast milk must be poured inside the cup. Let me destroy this lie, this evil lie. The tit sucking business of Muhammad is already evil, but let me destroy this one too, because that's what they have claimed for the last 1400 years. Ya Muslimin, you have been deceived. Here is why. This claim, guys, this claim is here from Ibn Sa'd's Tabaqat al-Kubra. You see, this is the source, and it's quoted by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, he quoted it from Ibn Sa'd's Tabaqat al-Kubra. Now, let us see who the source of this hadith is. Who is the narrator that Sister Fifi and many others like Fifi who love to deceive their Muslim audience with? Brother, the milk, the breast milk must be poured inside a cup. That's what they said. But wait, let me spank them left and right. Let me destroy them and this evil life from the depths of hell. Are you ready, guys? Are you ready? Let me show you, and I want you to take a screenshot. I want you to take a screenshot right here, right now, of this hadith here that you see here on the screen, and use it in your debates. Whenever you talk about adult breastfeeding, and they will say, well, it must be inside a glass or a cup or a pot, brother. Not direct from the titty, brother. Not like this. No, you have to drink it from the pot or a glass or a cup, brother. Look. Ibn Sa'd's Tabaqat al-Kubra, which is quoted by Ibn Hajar himself, one of the giants in Islam. Same guy who gave tafsir for Sahih al-Bukhari, right? Fath al-Bari. Fath al-Bari by Ibn Hajar. That's his book where he is explaining Sahih al-Bukhari, right? Fath al-Bari by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. That guy, giant in Islam. And he's quoting this hadith. Read with me. And amount of drink, breast milk. Breast milk, brother. Like this, must be put inside the cup, brother. It must be put inside a cup, a pot, or glass. You must collect it in there. And Salim used to drink every day for 5 days. After this, he used to enter upon her. Her head was uncovered, right? That's this, the wife of Hudayfa, right? This was permission from Messenger of Allah to Sahla bin Suhail, the wife of Abu Hudayfa. Sahla bin Suhail, right? So it must be poured inside a pot or a glass or a cup. No direct contact between the lips of the Sahaba and the titty, the nipple, brother. But here comes the disaster. Take screenshot, guys. Again, if you didn't already, take the screenshot, take a selfie. But here comes the disaster. Who is the one who reported it? Who's the narrator? His name is Al-Waqidi. Muslims, I got you by your beards. Why? Why? Because Ibn Hajar, this Munafiq Ibn Hajar, who you claim he is one of the giants in Islam, he's quoting Al-Waqidi. Guys, do you understand what is going on? Ibn Hajar, in he's quoting the hadith of Al-Waqidi. Why is that a problem? Anyone has an idea? Anyone who has an idea why this is a disaster for the Muslimin? Why is this a disaster? Why Al-Waqidi is a no-no? Guys, come on. I hope you are paying attention. Why is this a disaster? No, it's not daif. Bam! Right, exactly, Epi Frenzy. Al-Waqidi is a liar and a fabricator. Muslims, guys, Muslims, Al-Muslimin, the Muslims, they reject Al-Waqidi. They reject his hadith. They call him a fabricator. Uh-oh. He's a liar, he's a fabricator. All of his hadith is matruk. He's matruk al-hadith. Laysa bithiqa when it comes to hadith. And this is the hadith of Al-Waqidi. Ya Ibn Hajar, ya Munafiq Ibn Hajar. Ya Fifi, you're a Munafiq. Mimi, you're also a Munafiq. Abu Nur, you're a Munafiq too. You're all liars and deceivers. Shame on you for quoting the hadith from Al-Waqidi. Ya Fifi, today I just destroyed you. And if any Muslim is following you on Twitter or YouTube, if they're really sincere about the truth, they should unfollow you today, grab you by your beard because you are quoting from a liar, a deceiver, a fabricator like Al-Waqidi. Guys, do you have any idea how I just destroyed Farida? I just destroyed Farida. All the Muslimin who are too embarrassed about tit-sucking business of Muhammad, they need to say it's there's no contact between the nipple of the woman and the lips of the Sahaba. No, you idiots. You are quoting from a fabricator, a liar. Al-Waqidi. Guys, I just spanked Farida and I ended his career. Guys, you need to download this video today after I'm done. Download this part and share it all over social media so that the Muslims will stop following such liars and deceivers like Farid, like Mimi Hijab, all of them. One by all these embarrassed, this is, I'm really embarrassed for the Muslimin who are following them, man. Muslims, you are idolizing these people. You are idolizing Farida. But Farida just lied to you. I just destroyed Farida and all the Muslim apologists who are too embarrassed to accept that the tit-sucking business of Muhammad actually happened between the nipple and the lips of the Sahaba. And we showed you the intro video. Even Aisha used to give her breast to strange men, right? Even Aisha used to suckle, not only her sisters. You saw the intro video, right? Aisha, you know, the mother, Habibatun Nabi, the baby bride of Muhammad, used to even give her breast to the Sahaba. Anyone got milk? Anyone is interested in some milkshake, brother? Today is the day, brother. We have a lot of milkshake for you, brother. Yeah, Muslimin. We have a lot of milkshake today. This is the milkshake business of Muhammad. Any Muslim? Any Muslim? Ya Muslimin, ya Ikhwan. Ya Ikhwan. Winkum, ya Ikhwan. I mean, my Skype is over. Where is Fifi? Yalla, Fifi. I'm destroying you. I am destroying you here, right now, and you are hiding from me. You see what kind of joker Farid is, guys? He is quoting from a weak hadith. And let me prove it. Al-Waqidi is a liar, a fabricator, and all of his hadith are rejected. He is rejected. Al-Waqidi is rejected. Yes, he is a famous historian, but all of his hadith is rejected. Wow. So they are quoting rejected hadith? Yes. One day, love to talk about. Brother, the breast milk must be poured inside a cup. Yeah, Fifi, I got you by your beer today. I just ended your career, yeah, Fifi. And your Muslim followers must be so proud about you and your lies. Ya liar, ya deceiver, ya jahil ibn jahil. A Christian must help the Muslims and destroy their heroes who are lying, who are too embarrassed to say we are quoting from a rejected source like Al-Waqidi. Watch, guys. Here is my proof. Are you ready, guys? I want you to also take screenshots from these parts. Muhammad ibn Umar bin Waqid al-Waqidi al-Aslami Abu Abdullah al-Madani. Now try to say that 10 times, guys. That's al-Waqidi. Short al-Waqidi. That's the guy, right? That same guy al-Waqidi. This guy al-Waqidi. Let me show you who are rejecting his hadith. The giants in Islam. Look who his criticizers are. Those who have made criticism on Al-Waqidi. Let me show you very famous names. And those are the giants. The number one that I want to talk. I'm only going to show you the biggest ones. Al-Shafi'i. The guy who is part of the four major Sunni madhabs. Sunni school of thought. That Al-Shafi'i. He calls him a fabricator. Here's more. Ahmad ibn Hanbal, another giant from the Hanbali, right, school. Number two, I'm not going to go through the whole list. I'm only quoting the giants. Here is another one. Imam Bukhari himself, guys. The Imam al-Bukhari who wrote Sahih al-Bukhari. He's calling him a fabricator. Imam Muslim who wrote Sahih Muslim. And look how many names there are. The list is huge. Sunan Abi Dawud, the guy who wrote Sunan Abi Dawud, Abu Dawud himself. An-Nisa'i, another giant. Al-Darqutni, and so on, and so on, and so on. The list is huge. Look how huge the list is. So, ya Fifi, ya Munafiq ibn Munafiq, shame on you for using a rejected hadith from a fabricator like Al-Waqidi. Guys, wow! You have no idea how I just destroyed. You have no idea, guys, people who are new to Islam. You have no idea how I just destroyed a 1400-year-old lie that Muslims keep telling us. No, there is no contact between the breast, the nipple, brother, and the lips of the Sahaba. You must pour it inside a cup, brother. It must be in a cup. You liars. Why are you quoting a rejected hadith? This is not even da'if. This is even worse than da'if, guys. Don't call it da'if. This is matruk. Totally rejected. Rejected is even more worse than da'if. Totally rejected, because remember, da'if is accepted. Guys, I think my new hobby is destroying Fifi and Mimi. I love to destroy these people, man. These liars and deceivers. I have no respect for lies and deceivers. You see how these modern Muslim apologists need to lie and even quote from rejected hadith? Before I continue, let me show you what Sister Fifi said about who? About the same guy that he is quoting from. Watch. Guys, put on your headsets and let me spank Fifi by Fifi's own words. Watch. Watch. Let me spank Fifi with his own words. Look what Fifi is going to say about Al-Waqidi.
In that sense. However, in my opinion, the biggest issue with the hadith is that it's reported by Muhammad bin Umar Al-Waqidi.
Who? Fifi who?
With the hadith is that it's reported by Muhammad bin Umar Al-Waqidi.
Al-Waqidi, the same Waqidi. Okay, what are you going to say about Al-Waqidi, Sister Fifi? Sister Fifi, what about Al-Waqidi? What do you want to say about Al-Waqidi?
Muhammad bin Umar Al-Waqidi is actually a fabricator of hadiths. He's been condemned. In my opinion, the biggest issue with the hadith is that it's reported by Muhammad bin Umar Al-Waqidi.
Yes.
Muhammad bin Umar Al-Waqidi is actually a fabricator.
He's a what? A fabricator. Thank you very much, Fifi. Ya munafiq Fifi, with your disgusting, filthy beard. I just got you with your beard. Why are you quoting from Al-Waqidi then? If he's a fabricator.
Hadiths, he's been condemned as a liar by many major hadith scholars.
Okay, then why are you quoting his rejected hadith? He's condemned, right? So why are you quoting his hadith? Ya Fifi. Ya munafiq, you liar, you deceiver. Now a fabricator, someone who's condemned according to you. Now you can use this hadith? Guys, did you just see how Fifi just destroyed himself? Do you see how Fifi just destroyed himself? Again.
Umar Al-Waqidi is actually a fabricator of hadiths. He's been condemned as a liar by many major hadith scholars, including Ali ibn Madini, Ishaq ibn Rahaway, Al-Nasa'i, and Abu Hatim Al-Razi.
You see, Fifi, I got you by your beard. I just got you by your beard. Did you guys hear? You heard him, right? He just confirmed that Al-Waqidi is a known fabricator and he's condemned by the giants of Islam, the scholars of Islam. You see how these people cherry pick what they want to use for their agenda? You know, when it suits their agenda, they're going to even quote rejected hadiths from fabricators like Al-Waqidi. I just destroyed Fifi his career, guys. Guys, Christians, listen carefully, Christians. I'm talking to you, Christians. I know a lot of you, and I'm not addressing all of you, a lot of you are very lazy. Honest to God, this is a sad reality. Don't say we are not lazy. Most of you are lazy. I want you to download this part. Share it all over social media and show how I, Rob Christian, just destroyed Fifi's career. Don't be lazy, Christians. Please, brothers in Christ, sisters in Christ, I want you to download this video because I just ended Fifi his career. Please, help me to help you. Today's live show is one of the live shows. Download this part because I am just using Fifi against Fifi. This part about him quoting fabricated hadith. Fabrication, brother. Fabrication, brother. Any proud worshipper of Fifi? Any Mohammedan who loves Fifi? Maybe you can help Fifi out because I just destroyed Fifi left and right. يلا يا مسلمين يلا. No Muslim dares to call us. Yeah, Fifi, I just got you. Finally, I got you quoting fabricated hadith. And you just condemned yourself because you yourself confirmed that he is a fabricator. Al-Waqidi is a fabricator and he is condemned. All right. And we showed you he was even using, you know, he used one of, you know, a couple of names in this list. Now, guys, let me show you even more. Look, the critics of Al-Waqidi, the critics of Al-Waqidi, let me give you the link, guys. Let me give you the link. So go to this part here. I gave you the link. Bookmark it, save it, guys. Look what it says. As for the critics of Al-Waqidi, there are many. Therefore, I would combine the list of very prominent names. We showed you Al-Shafi'i. Look what Al-Shafi'i says. Look at what Al-Shafi'i, one of the four. One of the four, right? Of the major madhabs. Right? This guy, giant in Islam. All the books of Al-Waqidi are lies. Oh boy. So Fifi, why are you using rejected hadith from a known liar? All of his books are lies. In Medina, there were seven men who used to fabricate authorities, one of which was Al-Waqidi. This is Al-Shafi'i talking. Ahmed ibn Hanbal, a giant from the Hanbali Sunni school of thought, right? He is a liar. Al-Waqidi is a liar. He makes alternations in traditions. A liar, a fabricator. Look what An-Nisa'i says. An-Nisa'i, the liars known for fabricating hadith. Who? Al-Waqidi himself. Right? And he's mentioning four of them. One of them is Al-Waqidi. Oh boy. Yeah, guys, one of my hobbies is to spank Fifi. You know, I became an expert in spanking Fifi. Yes, that's true. That's true. Al-Bukhari. Imam Bukhari, who wrote Sahih al-Bukhari. That guy. Yes, giant. Whose book comes immediately after the Quran. When it comes to authenticity. That Imam Bukhari. Al-Waqidi, Imam Bukhari says, Al-Waqidi has been abandoned in hadith. Matruk al-hadith. He fabricates hadith. So they are all condemning him. Look how many. Abu Dawud, look, who wrote Sunan Abi Dawud, one of the major six books, right? The authentic six books. Kitab al-Sitta. I do not write his hadith. The hadith of who? Of Al-Waqidi. And I do not report hadith on his authority. Look how many giants of Islam are condemning Al-Waqidi, condemning him to be a fabricator, a liar, and a deceiver. The list is huge, guys. Look. And I want to show you the Munafiq himself, Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. Why? Because it is Ibn Hajar. Guys, this video is such a disaster for the Muslims. You have no idea. Same Ibn Hajar who is quoting from the known fabricator. Look what he says. Look what the same Ibn Hajar, this Munafiq Ibn Hajar, who is supposedly another giant in Islam, he has been abandoned in spite of vastness of his knowledge. So, ya Ibn Hajar, ya Munafiq. Ya Munafiq Ibn Munafiq, ya Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. Why are you quoting then his hadith? Let it sink in, Muslims. Wow! Guys, this is huge. This is overwhelming. So this Munafiq Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani is using rejected hadith of a fabricator, a condemned person like Al-Waqidi? The answer is yes. In the end, they are all Munafiqun. One by one, all of them. From the biggest one all the way to the lowest one, which is Fifi today. Who is my special guest today. Yeah, Sister Farida is the disciple of Al-Waqidi, exactly. Because he's quoting the same hadith. You see, guys, how I'm spanking them one by one. The biggest one and the lowest one. Sister Fifi himself. this munafiq here. You are a munafiq. You are a miskin, ya Farida. You are a jahil and you are deceiving your audience. If I would be a Muslim, guys, honest to God, if I would be an honest, sincere Muslim, I would have unfollowed Fifi on social media now. I would unsubscribe from his YouTube channel, unfollow him on Twitter, because this liar, this deceiver is quoting from Al-Waqidi, like Ibn Hajar the Munafiq himself, who made this hadith very famous, but not telling everybody that Al-Waqidi is a liar and a deceiver. He's a known fabricator, right? So we spanked Ibn Hajar, we spanked Fifi, Mimi, all of them, one by one today. Any proud Muhammadan in the live chat who wants to call us? Today, Sister Fifi is leaking. He's leaking from all of his... Today, I'm forcing Farid, you know, to come up again on Twitter, on social media, and say, sorry, I quoted a fabricated hadith from a known fabricator like Al-Waqidi. If you are a man, ya Fifi, ya Fifi, ya Sister Fifi, if you are truly a man and you call yourself a man, and I know you're watching, and I know that my video will reach you, today, I challenge you to come up online. If you don't dare to call me, go on Twitter, go on YouTube and say, ya Muslimin, my followers, I used a fabricated hadith of Al-Waqidi. I deceived all of you. But this guy will never do it. He will never do it. This munafiq here. Busted. Shame on you, ya Fifi. Shame on you. Shame on Ibn Hajar for making this fabricated hadith, this rejected hadith, famous in Islam. And still today, Muslims who are deceived, they are still thinking, you know, there is no contact between the nipple of the woman and the Sahaba's lips. It must go inside a milk cup. Cup of milk, brother. Like this. See? Like this, brother. This is a must in Islam, brother. No, this is a lie. This is a fabrication. And I wonder why Muslims are not calling me. Because they know we just spanked Islam. We spanked the lie of Ibn Hajar. We spanked the lie of Al-Waqidi. We spanked Fifi, Mimi, all of them. All of them. So yeah, Mimi Hijab, you're allowed to suck on someone's titties, someone's wife's titties, because that's what Islam teaches. If you don't want to lust after that woman. And Bu Noor, you are a munafiq. At least Mimi Hijab got it right this time. Mimi Hijab got it right this time. And Fifi is a liar, a munafiq. Bu Noor, you are a munafiq. All of you are munafiqeen. Because you are quoting from a rejected hadith. Any Muslim? No Muslim? Why? Guys, are you enjoying the show? Or am I putting you asleep? Are you enjoying the show? Are you benefiting from today's live show? Or should I wrap this up? What do you think? Should we wrap this up? Or should we continue? I didn't even go to today's main topic, guys. I'm so motivated to spank and destroy Fifi's lies and people like Fifi. I didn't even go to the main topic today. I didn't even start. Are you enjoying the show? I hope you have a lot of popcorn and a lot of nice drinks because I'm not finished. I am going to continue bringing down the hammer on the Prophet of Islam. Prophet with an eye, so to speak. So this is the main topic, guys. The true love story between Muhammad and his daughter-in-law, Zainab bint Jahsh. Zainab, the daughter of the donkey. That's her last name. Papam, papam, papam. Any Muslim? No Muslims? Muhammad was a real pervert, a real son of Satan, a bastard for lusting after the wife of his adopted son, Zayd bin Muhammad, his own adopted son. And remember, Zayd right? Zayd was adopted by Khadija and Muhammad, right? Zayd used to be a slave, but he became the son of Muhammad and Khadija. Did you catch it? So that's why he was called Zayd bin Muhammad. Not Zayd ibn Abdullah, no, Zayd ibn Muhammad. Right? So he became his son. Imagine, guys, and that's how the story goes. Imagine. Zayd, put yourself in his shoe. Zayd is not at home. Muhammad, his father, wanted to visit Zayd one day. And he comes to, and he knocks on the door of Zayd, and no one is opening the door. No one is opening the door. No one, no one is answering. And Muhammad, the evil bastard, son of bastard, Muhammad, the prophet of Islam, enters. And what does he, who does he see instead of Zayd? He sees the wife of his son, Zayd bin Muhammad. Exactly. In this kind of state. Half naked, brother. No covering on her head. No hijab. Nothing, brother. Look. So Muhammad sees her like this, basically. That's Muhammad. What Muhammad was now doing. Put Muhammad in, put him inside, put yourself in a shoe. In the shoe of Muhammad. Brother, look how beautiful Zainab is. And Muhammad says, oh, wow. Boom, 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 boom. This is his heart. Boom, boom. Subhan muqallib al-qulub, Muhammad says immediately. Who? Glory to Allah. Who turns my heart. Who turns hearts, Muhammad said. And he blames Allah for lusting after the wife of his son, his own daughter-in-law, Zainab bint Jahsh. Boom, boom. I mean, his heart is going to pop out of his chest, brother. Boom, boom. Right? This is Muhammad, brother. Subhan muqallib al-qulub. And Muslims will tell you, brother, this is da'if. This is fabrication, brother. This did not happen, brother. Are you sure? And when we go to At-Tabari, for example, guys, this is At-Tabari. Right? This is At-Tabari. Yeah, the website is messed up for some reason because I made it big. Let me make it smaller a little bit. See? Chapter 33 of the Quran, ayah 37. Tafsir al-Quran, al-Tabari. The creme de la creme. Who? The creme de la creme. The giant of tafsir himself, al-Tabari. And when we talk about this story, right? When we talk about this story, guys, Muslims will tell you, no, this is fabrication, brother. It did not happen, brother. Why? Anyone knows why? Anyone in the live chat knows why they call it a fabrication? Right? Because the tafsir saying here that Muhammad started to lust after her and, she came inside his heart, basically. He started to lust after her. And they say, no, Muhammad did not lust after her. Why are they calling it da'if? Anyone in the live chat? Peter M., of course, it's embarrassing. Yeah, that's one of the main reasons. But why are they calling it da'if? Anyone has an idea? This is Tafsir al-Tabari, guys. And this part here that you see here, that we just mentioned, Muhammad entering and he says, she fell into my heart. Basically, I started to lust after her. They say this is fabrication, this is da'if. No. The reason is because of this guy here. The narrator of the story. Right? Ibn Zayd. Not the Zayd of the son of Muhammad. This is another guy who is reporting it. Right? Qala Ibn Zayd. So they call Ibn Zayd, this guy, they call him a liar. What is his full name? His full name is Ali bin Zayd bin Judan. This guy that you see here, they call him, they say he's da'if, right? The guy in the chain, right? The guy in the chain, the last guy in this case, he is da'if. He is rejected, basically. He is not trustworthy. That's what they say, This guy that I just highlighted, Ali bin Zayd bin Jud'an. They call him a liar. That's why. You see, they even throw their people who are reporting the stories about Muhammad and Zainab, they throw them under the bus. Right? That's why. But wait, why here in Sunan ibn Majah, Book 5, Hadith number 361, Hadith 1163, why it's Sahih then? Suddenly it's Sahih. Uh-oh. Guys, he is the one in the in the chain. He's the last guy in the chain. Right? He's the last guy in the chain. Right? This is his name. Zayd bin Jud'an. Same guy. Why then this hadith is sahih if he is supposedly da'if? If his reports are da'if. Did you catch it, guys? Did you see how I just destroyed their lie again? So it's not da'if. But they are throwing him under the bus because they are too embarrassed about Muhammad stealing the wife of his adopted son, Zayd bin Muhammad. This guy here, they are throwing him under the bus. This guy, Ali bin Zayd bin Jud'an. This guy. Right? That's what Fifi and others like Fifi will tell you. Ali bin Zayd bin Jud'an is a liar and deceiver. And that's the same guy here. Ibn Zayd. It's the same guy. Ibn Zayd. You see it? Ali ibn Zayd bin Jud'an. Right? Do you see it? I have more proof that this guy is not da'if as they claim. Here. Here is a book. Right? Here is a book that explains Sahih al-Bukhari, volume 3, and it's written by Imam Ubaid Allah bin Sulaiman al-Jabiri. If you like, you can take a screenshot, guys. He's going to show you that he is trustworthy, that this guy that we mentioned, Ibn Zayd bin Jud'an, he is trustworthy in this book here. Watch. Look, Ali bin Zayd bin Jud'an, thiqa, trustworthy. He is what? Trustworthy. So Zayd ibn Zayd is trustworthy. This is page 303 of this book. Guys, I know it's hard maybe because you don't know Arabic, but you need to trust me on this. I did my homework very, very well. I went deep in their books to find this. So you see, he's called trustworthy in this book. Right? We showed you that his hadith is sahih. He's the one in the chain. He's the last guy in the chain, right? Zayd bin Jud'an, same guy. He's the last guy, and the hadith is sahih. But they love to throw him under the bus to save Muhammad's tiny little, So he's thiqa, he's trustworthy. Ali bin Zayd bin Jud'an, same guy, he is trustworthy. If this is not enough, let me go to the book of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, the Hanbali school of thought. One of the four Sunni schools, right? That guy. Musnad Ahmad ibn Hanbal, volume 8. Musnad Ahmad ibn Hanbal, volume 8. Take a screenshot if you like, guys. In his book, volume 8, this book is written by Ahmad ibn Hanbal, the guy of the Hanbali school. Let me prove more that he is not rejected. He's not a fabricator. He's not da'if. He is trustworthy. Watch. Ali, on page 60 of this book of Musnad Ahmad, volume 8, on page 60 in the Arabic, Ali bin Zayd bin Jud'an, indana thiqa, he is trustworthy. He, with us, he is trustworthy. That's what Ahmad ibn Hanbal in his book, in his Musnad, Ahmad ibn Hanbal, volume 8, is saying. Ali bin Zayd bin Jud'an, he is trustworthy. Alright? Same guy who's reporting this story about Muhammad lusting after Zainab, his own daughter-in-law, the wife of his son, Zayd bin Muhammad. Bam! You see, guys, I really did my homework. It took me a lot of time to gather all this information, to destroy their lies, their taqiyah, throwing their own people under the bus because they are so embarrassed about the pervert who they call the Prophet of Islam. Guys, I think, you know, I love Brother CP. Brother CP is doing a lot of damage. But guys, I need your support too. I need your support too. Right? I know you love to watch CP, and, but not, you know, maybe sometimes CP won't mention things, so we have to do that too. So, you know, we are all, right? We're basically all the, we are not scholar. I'm not a scholar. God forbid, I'm not a scholar. But all the Christian apologists who are putting their lives on the front lines, you need to download our videos, you need to watch our videos, guys. I know you love to go and watch CP. CP is very funny and so on. But guys, you need to support all of us. If you want to take down this evil cult, if you want to see this evil cult die very soon, you need to download our videos and spread our videos, information all over social media. Not only CP. I know CP is famous. I love him. He's a true living legend for me. He's one of the true living legends when it comes to destroying Muhammad and this evil cult. But he's not the only one, right? Please support all of us. All right. So we showed you from this book, from Imam Ubaid Allah bin Sulaiman al-Jabiri, we showed you from the hadith that Zayd bin Jud'an, Ali bin Zayd bin Jud'an, everything he's saying is sahih. See it? But they love to throw him under the bus. And we showed you from Musnad Ahmad that he is trustworthy. Thiqa. Right? Thiqa means trustworthy. Right? Right? Thiqa. Bi thiqa. Thiqa. He is trustworthy. Here, let me play this part for you guys. For example, this.
جدير بالثقة.
ثقة, right? This word here. Trustworthy. Right? Trustworthy. ثقة. So he's trustworthy. That's what all the books are saying about this guy who reported the story that Muhammad fell. He started to lust after Zainab bint Jahsh. And they love to say, no, this is false, brother. It's fabrication, brother. We reject it, brother. Who are you to reject it? Ya Muslimin, who are you to reject it? Well, it's reported by very sahih chain guy. Sahih, brother. He is trustworthy. Right? All right. Let me continue. I know this is a lot of meat, especially if you don't know Arabic. It's hard to swallow. But it is what it is. I have to go to the Arabic guys to prove my point. Right? I have to go to the tafsirs. If we go to Tafsir al-Qurtubi, right, for the Quran, Tafsir al-Qurtubi, volume 7. And here comes a really disgusting story. And Zainab is going to say the following about her husband, Zayd bin Muhammad, her original husband, the son of Muhammad himself. Look what Zainab, is going to say what Allah did to Zayd. So Zainab is going to say, guys, Zainab, she's going to say, Allah did the following to my husband, Zayd bin Muhammad. Right? Allah did the following to my husband, Zayd bin Muhammad. Are you ready, guys? This is really evil. This is really disgusting. And I mean, what is the difference then between Allah and Satan in Islam? Now you'll see that Allah and Satan are the same guy. And I'm not going, you know, we don't believe there's something called Allah, but they believe in Allah. And I want to ask the Muslims, if I'm going to show you the following proof from your own books, what is the difference between Satan and Allah? What is the difference between Satan and Allah when you read the following? Where? In Tafsir al-Qurtubi for the Quran, volume 7, in Jama' al-Ahkam, lil-Ahkam, volume 7, Tafsir al-Qurtubi for the Quran, right? We can read on page 139. Page 139. Look what it says. Zainab herself is reporting this. Who? Zainab is reporting this. That's Zainab. This is Zainab here, basically. She's saying that Zayd, inna Zaydan, tawarrama thalika minhu. Uh-oh. So what is Zainab saying, guys? What is Zainab saying? Zainab is saying, in the Arabic, Zayd's penis, I kid you not, this is what Zainab is saying. Zayd's penis started to what? Swell. So when Zayd wanted to F his wife Zainab, so the son of Muhammad wanted to start to F Zainab, every time he wants to F Zainab, Satan, I mean Allah, is making his penis huge. So his penis become huge, it starts to swell, so he cannot F his wife. The miracle of Allah. Brother, Allah is causing Zayd's penis to swell up, so he cannot start to F Zainab. Why? Because Allah wants to give her to Muhammad. This is Quran. Brother, this is Quran? Yes, this is Quran. Allah in his Quran is saying this. Allah, I mean Satan, is causing the penis of Zayd, the son of Muhammad, the adopted son of Muhammad, his penis to start to swell so he could not F Zainab anymore, because Allah reserved Zainab for Muhammad, brother. Ya khabar abiyad. Ya Muslimin. Your Allah did what to the penis of Zayd? Oh boy. Oh boy. So Allah made Zayd's penis start to swell? Yes, brother. That's what the tafsir is saying. This is tafsir for the Quran. See it? Tafsir al-Qurtubi, volume 7. And here also, we can find it also here. Right? Same ayah, same chapter. Chapter 33, ayah 37. It's also mentioned here. Right? Let me give you the link too. Because basically the same, right? Only this is the online version, and this is the book version. So they... what you can find here, they put it on altafsir.com, right? Tawarrama minhu. Inna Zaydan tawarrama thalika minhu. His penis started to swell. Oh boy. Any Muslim? Any? Ya Muslimin. Winkum ya Muslimin. Please help Zayd's penis, brother, because Allah, brother, he started to swell the penis of... Allah has nothing better to do. Allah has no other business than causing people's penis to swell up. Allah and Muhammad, guys, Muhammad had a tit-sucking business, and Allah had a penis-swelling business. Allah has a penis-swelling business. Is this my book or is this your book, ya Muslimin? Is this Al-Qurtubi for Quran or not? Is this Al-Qurtubi's book for the Quran or not? Inna Zaydan tawarrama thalika minhu. His penis started to swell. Allah causing the penis of Zayd to swell. He cannot F his wife anymore. He cannot F Zainab anymore. Because Allah wanted to give Zainab to Muhammad. And this is the reason why Zayd gave his own precious wife to Muhammad in marriage. He could not F her anymore. Allah made a miracle so that Zayd cannot start to F, to have sexual intercourse with his wife anymore. Every time Zayd wants to F his wife, his penis becomes like a balloon. Allah is blowing on the penis of, Allah loves to give oral action, right? Remember? Quran again. Allah has a blowing up business and he always loves to blow on private parts. Remember this ayah, guys? Remember this ayah in the Quran, chapter 66, ayah 12? Allah loves to blow on, right? التي أحسنت فرجها فنفخنا فيه. Allah is saying, Allah loves to blow up Maryam like a balloon. So Allah loves to blow on private parts. You know, if it's a male or a female, it's a woman or a male, no, you know, Allah doesn't mind. Allah doesn't care about the sexes. You see, Allah always blowing on private parts. Allah is into the blowing business of sexual private parts, brother. Any Muslim, ya Muslimin, yalla ya akhwan, ya Yasmin, are you with us, Yasmin? What do you think about this? That the Muslims must believe that Allah blows up the penis of the poor man, the son of Muhammad himself, that he cannot start to F his wife Zainab anymore. Because Allah wanted to give her to Muhammad, brother. That's the true love story right there. That's the love story of the Prophet and Zainab, brother. What do you want to say to these kind of Muslims who must believe in this? That Allah is inside, you know, he's doing business. He's blowing up private parts of Muslims. Poor guy, man. No Muslims, guys. Why is that? I have at least 6 dislikes and not one Muslim dares to call me? I wonder why. My Skype is open, yeah, Muslimin. My Skype is open. Why are you not calling me? Yalla. Defend the Prophet, man. Defend Allah, who loves to blow private parts up. Anyway, guys, and by this we wrap today's live show up. You know, I want to wrap this up. So if we have any calls from Christians, maybe you want to share something, maybe you want to add on top what we said today, you know, what do you want to, maybe you want to share something, maybe you can add up to what we said, maybe I forgot to mention things today. You know, your input is welcome. So the lines are open also now for the Christians. Any Christians who wants to call? Guys, don't time out Yasmin. Who, admins, what's wrong with you, admins? Why are you timing her out? She's saying she's being timed out. She's a sister in Christ, guys. What's going on there? Who timed you out? I don't see that someone timed her out. Yasmin, I don't think you're time out, sister. No. It was a mistake. Okay. No problem. Yasmin, what do you want to say to the Muslimin who are still in this cult of Muhammad, this sex cult of Muhammad, always fabricating Quranic ayahs? I mean, it's Quran, right? Always fabricating Quranic ayahs, right? So that Allah will run and to fulfill his sexual desires. Because remember what Aisha used to say. Remember what Aisha used to say? مَا أَرَى رَبُّكَ إِلَّا يُسَارَ فِيهَا وَكَ يَا مُحَمَّدٍ. Aisha used to say, I see that your Lord Allah runs to fulfill your desires. Hello?
Hi, Rob.
Hello, welcome. You're live on air.
Thank you very much. How are you?
I'm good. You're a Christian, my friend?
Definitely.
Oh, welcome.
Rob, I just want to add, on top of Muhammad and Zainab, I heard CP say that I'll blame Muhammad for...
Can you come closer to the mic, my friend? I'm not, You know, you're not clear enough. Can you come closer to the mic, please?
Oh, wait, let me. I think I'm out of Wi-Fi range.
Yeah.
Is that better?
Yeah, I think it's better. Go ahead. Speak louder, please. And yeah, go ahead.
Oh, okay. Well, I heard on a live stream that CP had with David and Sam.
Yes.
About Allah saying to Muhammad that he mustn't lie about his lust that he felt for Zainab.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what the, you know, that's what the Quran is saying. Right? The Quran is saying to Muhammad, don't feel ashamed. You know, you said to Zayd, to your own son, you said to him, keep your wife. No. I, Allah, I'm telling you. That's the Quran. Let me show you. That's what the Quran is saying, right?
Yeah, sorry.
You said to Zayd. Yeah. Let me put it on the screen and I can read it for you. Just a second, my friend. If we go to the ayah, you'll see that Allah himself is giving Zainab to him. Look. And oh, dear Prophet, Allah is saying, remember when you said to him, to who, Zayd, upon him, Allah has bestowed favor on you, had bestowed favor. Keep your wife, ya Zayd. Muhammad, those are the words of Muhammad that you see here, right? Oh, Zayd, oh, my son Zayd, keep your wife with you, Zainab. Right? This is Muhammad. That's what Muhammad is saying. You can keep Zainab, ya Zayd ibn Ibni, right? My son. And fear Allah. Taqillah. Fear Allah. And you kept in your heart what Allah will to make known. So, you know, Allah started to lust after Zainab. But, you know, he kept it in his heart. He didn't want, you know, I mean, it's the wife of his son. Right? And you feared criticism. Look, Allah is saying to Muhammad, you are fearing people. Their criticism. Because the people started to talk. Right? The people in Medina and Mecca, they started to talk. Look at this evil pervert. This son of Satan. This bastard Muhammad. Who claimed to be the last prophet. The seal of all the prophets. He's lusting after the wife of his adopted son. Right? Mm. And you fear criticism from the people around you. And Allah has more right that you should fear him only. And you know, look, Muhammad is fabricating here, right? Muhammad is the one who writing this. And he's saying, no, it's Allah who gave me the right to have Zainab. So look what it says. So when Zayd became unconcerned with her, so when Zayd didn't want to have Zainab anymore, I mean, we just read for you from the same chapter, same ayah, right? This is Tafsir al-Qurtubi for the same chapter, chapter 33, same ayah. That every time Zayd wants to have sexual intercourse with Zainab, Zainab is saying, well, every time Zayd wants to come and F me, that's what Zainab is saying, Allah is making his penis swell. And that's why Zayd cannot F her. And he says, okay, you can have her. Muhammad, you can have her. She's my wife, yes, but you can have her now. So Zayd doesn't need Zainab anymore. He cannot F her anymore. His penis starts to swell. We, Allah is saying, we gave her to you in marriage. You see it? So who is causing the penis of Zayd to swell up? Allah. And Allah is reserving her to get married to Muhammad.
Mm.
So who is to blame? Who is to blame? Allah. So can you tell me, right? And I want the Muslims, if the Muslims are listening, what is the difference between Allah and Satan? You Muslims say Satan is evil, but who is the evil now? Allah or Satan? I mean, what is the job of Satan if Allah is causing someone, a husband, his penis to swell up? Right?
Mm.
Go ahead.
Just so that his wife can go to the prophet.
Sorry?
Just so that his wife can go to the prophet.
Yeah. My friend, you are really not clear. Guys, maybe it's me, but I really can't understand what you're saying, brother. What did you say? Okay, you have too much noise in the background.
I said...
Yes.
He only did it so that he could have Zainab for himself.
Yes, he wanted Zainab for himself, exactly. He lusted after her. And we showed you that even the last guy in the chain who they call a liar, right? He's not trustworthy. We showed from Musnad Ahmad. We showed from Ubayd Allah. bin Sulaiman al-Jabiri, his book, that he's very trustworthy. You see, Zayd bin Jud'an, he's trustworthy, thiqa, right? He's thiqa, and from also Musnad Ahmad bin Hanbal, his book, right? Ali bin Zayd bin Jud'an, he is thiqa, he's trustworthy, right? So they are throwing a guy, poor guy, under the bus. Well, this guy is giving us a good report. It's sahih. It's trustworthy. This guy here that I highlighted. Yeah. And the story, this is the story that we mentioned today. And they say, this guy, Ibn Zayd, Qala Ibn Zayd, the last guy, he's a liar. We reject what he's saying. Why? Everything he's reporting, look, the same guy. Ali bin Zayd bin Jud'an said, right? This is an example of an hadith, and it's sahih. Every source say that everything he's reporting is sahih. So why are you throwing him under the bus? Because you are too embarrassed about the story? Muhammad lusting for Zainab, his daughter-in-law?
Mm.
See?
Yeah. Well, maybe you heard the story of David and then thought, I can do that too.
Yeah. Of course. And you know, they love to go to the Bible. They say, well, Solomon did the same. But wait, what did God, our holy God, our living God of the Holy Bible, what did he say? Did he say, yes, continue, Solomon, or Solomon, continue? Or did he say to King David, continue? No. God punished them.
No.
But Allah is the one who is doing this. Allah is saying to Muhammad, continue, go after. I gave her to you, and I made the penis of your son Zayd bin Muhammad swell. Every time Zayd wants to F his wife, his penis starts to swell. This is Tafsir al-Qurtubi, ya Muslimin. Tafsir al-Qurtubi, volume 7, page 139. إن زيدا تورم ذلك منه. His penis start to swell. Who is doing that? Allah. You see these hypocrites? Did our God in the Holy Bible, did our God punish King David and his son Solomon? Or did he say to them, go ahead, continue effing all these women? No.
Of course they got punished.
Yeah.
And David's firstborn from that woman he died.
Exactly.
Solomon was the second child from the marriage.
Yeah, God punished Solomon. God punished King David for their wrongdoings and sins. And they had to repent. They repented, right? They repented for their mistakes.
Correct. I mean, Solomon had to listen in the temple that he was commissioned to build. He had to listen to the adultery that his father and his mother committed.
Yeah. So what do you want to say to the Muslims who are listening? What do you want to tell them? What is your message to them after knowing that this is a very sahih story? They cannot reject it. What do you want to say to them?
I would advise them to follow Sister Yasmin Qureshi's path and leave this evil cult.
Yasmin already left. She left that other day on our live show, Life on Air, and she became a Christian. I mean, if she can leave.
Yeah,
she used to be a Muslim, right? A Muslima. She left because she knew Muhammad cannot be a prophet of God. This guy is an evil pervert, a filthy son of Satan, a son of a bastard for fabricating Quran, fabricating Islam. Islam is a man-made religion created by Muhammad for his sexual desires, right?
Mm.
And calling Allah God. There's nothing, there's no God. It's Muhammad, always Muhammad, who is fabricating Quran for his own sexual desires, claiming that it's Allah who gave Zainab to him. All right? Subhan muqallib al-qulub. Subhan muqallib al-qulub. Glory to Allah who turns my heart, Muhammad said. Oh, man.
Oh, so funny.
Yeah. All right, my friend. Do you want to say something else? Maybe we can take other calls. What do you... Any last words?
Maybe? No. I'd rather have you take other calls. I love listening to you guys. You guys are doing a lot of work. I'm actually trying to learn apologetics from you.
I hope so, you can take notes, my friend. Take screenshots. I hope that my live shows will not go in vain. Guys, our time is really precious. I know, like I said before, I know you love CP. You love many Christian apologists. But every Christian apologist, I want you to support every Christian apologist, because you can actually count us on your fingers. There are not many who are doing what we do. You have Brother Adam Seeker. I love that brother, right? He's a new upcoming Christian apologist. Support all the warriors, guys. Don't support just one. Please, for the love of God, support all of us, because you can count us on your fingertips. There are not many, right? Especially in the English section of YouTube, right? There are many in the Arabic section. There are amazing brothers and sisters in the Arabic section on YouTube who are destroying Islam left and right, but there are not many who are doing this for the English people, right? For the English-speaking people around us.
I just wish I knew Arabic.
Yeah. All right, my friend. Thank you for calling. God bless you. Thank you. And see you maybe in the future, can Lord willing. Thank you for calling.
Thank you, Rob.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hey. Bye. Bye.
All right. Thank you for that call. Any other callers, guys? Any more callers? Yesterday, guys, I joined the live show of our brother Adam Seeker, and we mentioned this topic too. We debated a Muslim who had no answer. I asked him, right, if you were there yesterday. I asked the guy. It was yesterday. We had a debate with a Muslim. And I asked him, imagine if your father is Muhammad, your own father who gave birth to you, who made your mother pregnant, your own father, imagine he goes to your house, you are not at home, your wife opens the door, and your father goes in, and your wife looks like this, half naked. And your own father, imagine your own father starts to lust after your wife. What would you say about your father? What would you do to your father? Would you still consider him to be your father? Or are you going to call him an evil son of Satan and a pervert? But hey, since it's the prophet of Islam, brother, it's okay. I mean, this is Muhammad, brother. This is the prophet, brother. It's okay because it's Muhammad. There are no limitations for Muhammad. He can steal someone's wife. I mean, it's the prophet, brother. It's Allah who gave him Zainab. It's Allah who is swelling up the penis of Zayd. It's always Allah, brother. Ya Muslimin, please wake up. Ya Muslimin, wake up. Why are you allowed to be deceived by Muhammad after 1400 years? Why do you follow this evil man who is creating the Quran for his own sexual desires? Created Islam for his own sexual desires. Why? Do you even have any dignity, ya Muslimin? Imagine this is your wife. This is your wife, your own precious wife. And Muhammad, let's say Muhammad is now living in the year 2021, right now. And he comes and sees you. He calls himself your father. And he enters upon your wife. You're not at home. And he starts to lust after your wife. What would you say to him? But no, it's Muhammad. Everything is okay when Muhammad does that. Because it's Muhammad, brother. It's the prophet, brother. Ameen, ya Yasmin. Al-Masih huwa al-Rabb. Ameen. Yasmin, again, is saying like last time, Jesus is the Lord. The Messiah is the Lord. Hallelujah to that. Ameen. Ameen, ya Yasmin. Amen to that. Yeah. Any Muslim, any Muslim who cares about the truth, any sincere Muslim, don't hold back. I'm not going to bite you. If you want to call us, don't be scared. Don't be scared. Call us. If Yasmin can, someone like Yasmin can leave Islam. If someone like Riyaz Qureshi, one of our admins, can leave Islam. If Adam Seeker, who is also one of my dear brothers and admins, that Adam Seeker, if he can leave Islam after 40 years, why can't you? Guys, the smart ones are the ex-Muslims. I kid you not. If you are smart, you will not accept this evil cult of Muhammad, who created Islam for his penis. Guys, My YouTube channel, for the people who know me, I am not political correct. I say things as they are. You don't like what we do, please leave. My YouTube channel is not for you. You like the truth, only the truth, then you are very welcome here. Right? We don't sugarcoat. We read the Islamic books as they are. I mean, what is the difference between Allah and Satan? If Allah is the one responsible for swelling up the penis of Zayd. Because, you know, Allah wanted to give Zainab to Muhammad, brother. So Allah started to swell up the penis of Zayd. Every time he wants to F, look, it's in the Arabic. Every time he wants to approach, look what the Arabic is saying. Every time Zayd wants to approach his wife Zainab, right? Every time he wants to approach her, to F her, Allah is causing his penis to swell up. That's what the Arabic is saying here. Anyone in the live chat who can confirm, if you're an Arabic speaker, you can confirm, right? That's what the Arabic of Tafsir ibn Kathir, Tafsir al-Qurtubi is saying for chapter 33, ayah 37. We gave you the link, guys. Here's the link again. You can read it. This is the kingdom website of Jordan. The king of Jordan owns this website. He's a Sunni Muslim, right? And this is from directly from the book of Al-Qurtubi. Any Muslim, ya Muslimin, ya Akhwan, wenkum ya Akhwan, why are you hiding from me? Why are you hiding from me? Do you have any dignity? Do you have any guts? Why are you not defending your prophet? I mean, you can give me many dislikes. Keep Muslims, I know you're watching. Keep the dislikes coming in, ya Muslimin. You cowards, keep giving me dislikes. I love your dislikes. Don't you see what my bot is saying? Muslims, it's okay to give me a dislike. That's what my bot is saying. We love dislikes from the Muslims. But Christians, give us a like. Give us a like, brother. Right? Christians, give us a like. Hello, welcome. Don't forget to like and subscribe and click on the bell to receive notifications. Oh, man. This is really embarrassing, man. This is really embarrassing. Any more calls, guys? Is there any more calls? Christians, the lines are open. For the people who do not know, the lines are open. Any Christian wants to add something on top of what we said? Maybe Adam Seeker, I'm not sure. I think Adam Seeker is really tired. Adam Seeker even broke my own record, right, for streaming. Yesterday he streamed for more than 6 hours, guys. Imagine, 6 hours. The guy was done. He was cooked in the end. Poor guy. But he did an amazing job, guys. And it was really a pleasure for me to join him and debate the Muslim. Right? The Muslim didn't dare to answer the question. I told him, I asked him, ya Muslim, pretend that this is your father. What were you going to do? Pretend that Muhammad is your father and he comes to see you, but you are not at home. He doesn't know that. And he sees your wife half naked like this, in this kind of state. And he says, Subhan muqallib al-qulub. Glory to Allah who turns my heart. Boom, boom. This is your father. What would you say to your father about? What would you call your father? But hey, since it's Muhammad, brother, it's okay. Look at the hypocrisy. Look at the hypocrisy of these Muslims, man. Who bloop? No. I already gave that idiot a chance. I'm not going to waste my time with this kid. No. I want sincere Muslims who care about the truth. I'm not going to waste my time with people like Ultimate Fart and... Any Muslim? Ya Muslimin? Yalla, ya Muslimin. Yalla, yalla, yalla. Yalla, ya Shabab. Yalla, yalla, yalla. Yalla, ya Shabab. Mayday, mayday. Yalla, ya Muslimin. No answer. Oh, boy. You see, we have another person who is calling himself ex-Muslim in the live chat. We are happy for you that you left Islam too, my friend. Mr. or Sister ex-Muslim. We are happy for you too. You see how many ex-Muslims we have in the live chat, guys? Islam is truly dying. Islam is sinking. Only the smart ones, like Sister Yasmin, like ex-Muslim here, Riaz Qureshi, Adam Seeker, oh, a lot of them. Only the smart ones leave this cult. But the stupid idiots, right, love the evil of Islam, of Muhammad. This is why you're still in that cult. You must be truly deaf, mute, and blind to stay in this cult. Truly. Yeah, but the tsunami is happening because of the internet, guys. Right? No more calls, guys? No more calls? Do we have maybe a last call? Christians? Muslims? Don't say, Rob Christian, you're not allowing Christians to call in next time. Okay? Don't say... Don't say next time, Rob Christian, please allow us to call. Well, the lines are open for you, Christians, too. Right? Guys, again, please download our video. Don't ask me on, you know, I don't understand. People still keep sending me messages on Skype. They are spamming me. You have no idea how much spam I get, guys. Rob Christian, is it okay if we download your videos? Is it okay to if we can use your material? Do I really need to say that over and over? Yes, my material is yours. My videos are yours to use. They are free. If you want to use them, keep them free. Don't ask money for it. I'm doing this for free for you guys. Keep my videos, my material, and sources free, please. All right? We need to spread my videos. I can't do that on my own, guys. I want you. I need you to spread my videos. I can't do it on myself. I put all the time that I have in doing researches, reading books. I'm reading books. I'm doing research to expose Muhammad and his cult. Your job is to download videos and share our videos all over social media. You know, I know it's, you know, Muslims are too lazy to watch a complete live show, right? So the best thing to do, guys, if you're listening, download the video, cut parts that are very important. Like today, we discussed, right? We showed you that Al-Waqidi, his report, his hadith is rejected. Download these parts and share them. Make small videos, right? And share them. Because it's much easier to watch, let's say, a 5-minute video than a 3-hour live show, right? Umud saying, who was the first Muslim? Well, we discussed that yesterday, right? We discussed that on Adam Seeker, his live show yesterday. The Quran is all over the place. The Quran says Adam, then he says it's Abraham, then it's Muhammad. It's all over the place. Why, Umud, you are asking the wrong guy. I'm not a Muslim to answer that question. We need the Muslims to answer that question, right? The Quran is all over the place, and that proves again that Muhammad is the one who's fabricating, always forgetting what he said earlier. The Quran is saying Muhammad is the first Muslim. Then the other ayah is saying, no, it's Adam is the first Muslim. You know, it must have book. What do you expect? Yeah. Yeah, it's all over. Muhammad is all over the place. He keeps forgetting what he said earlier. Right? Yeah, and here, Phil Harrier already gave a link to an article. You can read that, and all the ayahs are written on that link. Thank you, Phil Herrera. And guys, always pay attention to our brother, Phil Herrera, because after we are done with the live show, he always posts all the sources, all the material that we used in the comment section. And Phil Herrera, brother, can you do me a favor, Phil? Can you also, you know, for example, this is one I made. I put this extra in it, right, to make it clear what the Arabic is saying. Can you, so now and then, take a screenshot and upload it somewhere and make, like, let's say, a tiny URL so that people can see this, right? Stuff like this, right? If you can rewatch the video again, bro, and take screenshots and also make tiny URLs or any URL, yeah, upload it somewhere so that people can see. Maybe add something on top of it here. You know, and put an arrow and explain what it says. If you can help, that would be awesome. Because I can't do everything for you guys, right? Like this one too, right? And this. that Allah is causing Zayd's penis to swell up the moment he wants to F his wife, Zainab. So, yeah. Okay, guys, I think we are out of calls. All right, no more calls. I think we should wrap this up. What do you think? Any last call? Last chance, guys? No calls? Okay. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the show. I really hope you enjoyed the show. I hope you benefited from today's live show. And please download our videos, like I said. God bless all of you. I love you. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being here. Pray, like I said, pray for our Indonesian brothers and sisters in Christ. You know about, maybe you already heard about the explosion in front of the cathedral. Thanks to the Lord, nobody died. Only the jihadis, the terrorists, died, right? They came with bicycles, right? With motorbikes. And they wanted to cause a huge explosion, kill as many Christians as they could. But thanks to the Lord, no Christian died. They got injured, yes, but nobody died. So keep our brothers and sisters in Christ in Indonesia, right, in your prayers, so that Christ will keep them protected and safe. Please pray for them. Keep them in your prayers, guys. Thank you for watching. God bless you. And Lord willing, we will see each other again very, very soon. Go with the peace of Christ. Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Every knee will bow. Every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. And Muhammad is nothing but an evil son of Satan. A bastard. A perverted fake prophet who created Islam for his penis. Nothing more, nothing less. Thank you for watching. And hello, welcome. Don't forget to like and subscribe and click on the bell to receive notifications.
Sister.
Muta muta.
No. Asake sake. Yeah.
My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge.
You want it, the thing that makes me what the guys go crazy for. They lose their minds the way I whine. I think it's time.
La 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 la.
Warm it up.
La 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 la.
The boys are waiting.
La 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 la.
Warm it up.
La 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 la.
The boys are waiting.
My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge.
You're on it. You want me to teach thee techniques that freaks these boys. It can't be bought. Just don't please get caught. Watch if you're smart.
La, 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 la.